Hello everyone, here we are back in the shop. I just recently done a video on my little wooden ore car, and I'm doing a mine scene on my layout, and I also couldn't find anyone who made a model of a mine cage. So right here is the mine cage. Also working on a head frame, and I'm working on the main bearing and the main pulley up there to lift the mine cage. So this actually, the way I got it set up, it'll lift it. I will make it functional on my layout, work from a winch, and it'll go down into the base of the layout. So it looks like it'll go down in there. The ore car does fit on the rails. This is all, as far as the mine cage here, it is all resin cast except for one piece. And then of course I've added the chain. So anyway, I've got I'm gonna get this back on the tripod here, and I'll show you the little kit I've made for it, and we'll move along from there. Okay, here's a better picture of the mine cage itself. It's, like I said, it's all resin cast. You can see how the ore car fits on it. Anyway, pull this out. You can see I have, let's see, pull this down here. I've cast in the wood, like the wood plank floor it would have, and also the rails are already cast into it. It's a really easy little kit to put together. You can see the tracks here where it'll ride up and down inside the head frame. I looked at a lot of pictures, and it's close to prototypical, not exact, but it's close enough. Anyway, here's the kit. Let's see here. You got the base, you got the two sides, the two roofs, the handrails, and the, I didn't cast this because it just make it out of a piece of wood as the main support beam in the middle, and then also the eye hook for the center. The only thing I don't have supplied is the a couple pieces of eighth inch square braces here. Oh, excuse me. There's a couple eighth inch braces right here. Those, you can make those out of eighth inch balsa or eighth inch basswood, either way. Anyway, I'm gonna get the parts together here, and then we'll go ahead and start putting it together. Just like anything else, I would tell you is with resin parts, make sure you wash them really good before you start getting mold release off of them, so that your paints will stick to them. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these washed, get them ready to put together, and we'll go over putting it together really quickly. Okay guys, here we are. I've got everything washed. You may have to clean off just a little bit of flashing, and then these just around the edges, and make sure they're nice and square. What I've done is there's a piece of wood supplied, and it fits the same width as up here at the top. So the first thing we're going to do is come in here, and I kind of just hold the block flush with the top there, and then I mark it with a pencil. I don't know where I'll leave my pencil. Anyway, they've been pre-marked here. So anyway, I mark those, and what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and mark both sides. Here's the first one. And there's the second one. Another thing you need to do is go ahead and this is cast, and so this piece here is really slick. So you just need to take some like 320, 220 grit paper and just rough the side up just a tad. Okay. Then you come back in here, mark the center, and then you're going to come a quarter inch on each side and make a mark. That quarter inch is the same width, all right, it's a half inch width of the main frame here. So what we're going to do is we got that done. So next thing I do is I use just regular old CA glue. I get this at Hobby Lobby, of course, but you know, many people make it. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and glue the piece of wood on both sides at first. This wood is the same width as the base of the base of the mine cage. So it doesn't take much glue. It really holds, this really holds well to the it'll hold, once it sets up, it'll hold really well. But you need to make sure you get it flush. Got flush with the top. All right, well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and get both of these glued, because what it does, it takes a minute to set. Once I get it set up, I'll come back and show you how we mount it to this. Okay, here we are back. What I've done is, like I said, I marked the center and then a quarter inch on each side, so it gives you a half inch down the middle. Then I come back from the edge here, 1/4 inch, and I did that both sides. So what we're going to do now, like I said, we sanded this, just lightly sanded this first, so we get a good glue joint. We're going to take this and we're going to glue let's see if I can turn this around. We're going to glue the middle one first on this side, and then we're going to pull this out, put a drop of glue, and we're going to glue the other side to the middle. Once those are set, we're going to come back and make sure that the arms coming down are glued to where the front point that touches is on that 1/4 inch mark. So that evens up everything. That mark's right there. So what we're going to do first is going to put a little bit of glue here. We'll come in here and make sure it sits down. And I'm going to attach this side and we'll hold it until it sets up. And then see, this is loose enough, I can pull that out and put a drop of glue in there, and then we'll pull it in place. We want to make sure this first side gets set first. Okay, see, it didn't take long. Okay. Now we need to make sure it matches up to the lines. And we're using the table to make sure it's flush along the bottom. Now I keep a piece of wood handy to get any excess glue off that comes up the side there. You can use a Q-tip, either way. But that's set. Now what we're going to do is take these pieces here and just make sure they're glued really close to that 1/4 inch mark on each side, around, all the way around. I mean, if it's not exact, it's fine, but it's really close to that 1/4 inch mark. So I'm going to get those other parts marked. Then I'm going to get a setup. I'll get these other four marked, and then we'll get set up to put the roof on. I'll be back. Okay, next thing I did is I got all this glued. I went ahead and marked the center of the block of wood. I took the little hook. Well, it's not a hook, it's a ring. This is that. But anyway, I drilled a really fine small hole just so I knew I was going down the center. And I put the screw eye in there. So that's in place. All right. Next thing we're going to do, we're going to take the two roof halves. Now, you need to take the roof halves, because they're really slick on the bottom. And just take them on a flat sanding surface and just sand them. And just you know, not hard, just we're just getting the slickness off of it. All right, now, the roof here has two different sides. One is totally flush, and the other has just a tad of overhang. The overhang goes away from the center, okay? So what we're gonna do is this roof half goes on here, and it needs to stay clear of this channel here. So it can go back to the channel, but not over, because this channel is what the mine cage locks into and goes up and down into the mine frame, the head frame. So what we're going to do is we've got this set up so it goes in place. These are all pre-cut. Now I think I'm going to have to go ahead and include the 1/8 inch basswood that goes in to as the supports. So what we're going to do is we've got to do this all at one time. We're going to put a bead of glue along the back here, We're going to hold this in place. You can mark it if you want, or you know, if you feel like you can hold it in the right place. And then the support, there's a really sharp angle and then a really short, a small angle on this on the bottom. The small angle goes towards the metal frame, and the sharp angle goes up to the roof. So what we're going to do is, as we hold this in place with the glue in place, we're going to pull this in and glue one of these in place also. Can you see it? It's going to glue in place there. Now, it's going to be flush with the back edge here, and it's just going to glue to the bottom edge of the roof. So this sets our angle, and also sets our angle for the other side. We can put the other one in later. So we're going to do this all at one time. Now, if you trial fit it like I've done here, you can go ahead and mark where it is on the bottom, and you can probably do that on both sides and just make it easier. So I'm going to go ahead and glue this in place, or I'll go ahead and glue all four of them in place, and then I'll come back and show you where we go from there. Okay, here we are. I got the roof in place. I'm going to kind of tell you how I did it. I took the one of the roofs to start off with, and I took on the thing here from the top corner down. I marked 1 inch. It just kind of gave me a guideline. So I took the roof piece and I ran a bead of glue all the way down. Let's see here, all the way down the edge, and then I just held it in place. Now it's going to tack faster to the resin piece than it does the wood. So it kind of tacked. It gave me I could let it go a little bit. And then I took my piece that I had, the angle piece that I had, and I kind of pulled this down, because you want a little bit of angle. What we're trying to do is get the same angle on it. And as I hold it in place, I go ahead and glue this first one in. All right, then I was able to glue the second one in. The main thing is, when you cut these, you want to make sure they're all exactly the same. So if I made a guide, and I'll provide a piece of 1/8 inch that is pre-marked, but you'll still have to make sure that they are all exactly the same. And I was cutting them with my little the chopper, which from Northwest Shortline. And so I was cutting with that. And so that doesn't always cut exactly straight when you're using basswood sometimes. So you may have to clean it up, but make sure all four of them are the same. Anyway, I did one side, then I turned around and did the other. Now this is good and sturdy. It's not going to go anywhere. And this is a really easy little kit. I mean, it goes together so fast. Next thing I did is I took my side rails and I laid them in here. They go down on, they secure to the top of the floor. And so I laid them in here and marked the top, where the top is. I don't know if you could see that in the video. And then I marked the center. Then I took this piece here and I marked the center of it. So what we're going to do is come in here and we'll just use CA glue, and we're just going to glue this in place. And then you're going to glue I glue this first in just the center. I don't do the back side here. And then we're going to lift this up and glue the foot or the base of it down on each side. So this is all marked. We're going to glue that in place, and technically we'll be done. This is something you can add. I did add a chain. It's just for looks. Some of the ones I saw online had nothing. I mean, you could just, they didn't have anything to stop anything. I guess a chain wouldn't stop a ore car from rolling off. But anyway, I put a chain here, and I got one on both sides. All that is a little, jewelry eye hook. Let's see if you can see it. And it's just cut off real short, and I drill a real small hole, stick it in, and then I made a chain. I took a piece of chain and went in between the two. So I just got that at like Hobby Lobby. And so I always have that on hand so I can do stuff like this. Anyway, all right, so I'm gonna glue this in place, and then we'll go through painting and weathering it real quick. Show you how I do it anyway. So I'm gonna get these two pieces glued on, and then we'll what I'm gonna do is go ahead and get it primed, and then we'll move along from there. Hey guys, here we are back. I've got the whole thing primed. You're shooting a really light coat on there. You're not shooting a really heavy coat. You do have to prime it. If you don't, the paints won't stick to it very well. I guess if you use some solvent-based paint, it may, but I use mostly acrylics to paint with. As far as primers, I use this Rust-Oleum American Accent Ultra Cover primer. Also bonds to plastic, so being as a resin or a plastic, it holds pretty good to that. So what I'm going to do is, on my research on looking these things up, most of them appear to be mostly gray in color. And I'm sure, you know, they got sooty and really weathered really easily going up and down in the mine and carrying all the stuff up. So anyway, I start out with, like I said, an acrylic. I'm using the Folk Art acrylic. This is a steel gray. You can use any color gray you wanted. So I start with that. I paint the whole thing except for the wooden floor. I will I'll do that in the desert sand, like I did in that the video for my my ore car. So I'm gonna get this painted. Just to let you know, when I cast this, I used HO scale rail. It is the appropriate width for the my ore car here. So they're kind of made to go together. This mine cage and the ore car, so it's all gonna go on the same layout. So anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get this painted. I'm gonna go ahead and get all the gray. I will come back. I'll go ahead and paint all the wood. Like I said, it's Americana desert sand, and I'll paint the rail using that. I forgot where I put it. The rust color, but it's the latex paint. Here it is. I had this mixed up a while back, and I use that to paint the rail. So I'm going to get all this painted, and then we'll come back and finish up on the video. Okay, guys, here we are back. I've got the whole thing painted. Got the gray, of course, the desert sand color, and then the rail color. I'm going to tell you the best thing to do is when you're painting the rail is go ahead and paint the rail first, because it's a little bit more tedious. And then you can take your brush with your desert sand and come right down the side of it and clean that up. I did want to tell you, I've done this in another video, is there's some really good brushes at Hobby Lobby. This is a set. I've taken these out, this one here, and then there's a rounded end one that I use. Every time I go to Hobby Lobby, if I'm not buying something else, I'll grab one of these. This and then the smaller set. Both of them are great sets of brushes to do this with. Once I got it all painted, I don't think you can get these anymore, but there's an old Floquil rust color pen. And I took and went down the edges and just added some fresh rust to the edges of it. I would mark it and then take my finger and rub it in, and it just adds a little bit of weathering to it. Our next step, and I also did the roof. I kind of streak it and then come back with a brush and rub it in. Ooh, that's still wet. Anyway, rub it in, and that would allow to give me a little bit more streaking. All right, our next step I'm going to do, because this is pretty much finished, is just kind of weather it. Is I've shown before, coming here, I've got my chalks. Those are I got Rembrandt and then some other chalks I bought in the past, but I keep them in this little thing. And I don't know if I'm sure y'all have used chalks before, but you just take a razor blade, let's see, and just scrape them. And that powder is what I use to weather with. Anyway, I'm going to now take, let's see here. Take this powder. This is a raw umber. I think that's what it is. It's the Rembrandt. I've used it before. It's it's the raw lumber, and it kind of gives me a good color on my wood, and it's good for the other all around. Just general, give me some discoloration of my paint. It also fills the cracks really good, or the kind of blends it all together. Let's see if I can get in here. Just kind of dulls it down. And the dry acrylics pick up that chalk pretty decently. I have some other colors in here, some black. Anyway, you can kind of see, it kind of dulls it all down. I don't know if you can see it in that light or not, but it really adds to it, makes it look pretty good. What I'm going to do is I'm going to finish that up. It takes a little while. Longer, you probably want to sit here and watch this. I did want to show you, I'm going to get the head frame out. I'm going to show you kind of how I did that. So this will track, and you can see that it... It was designed to go into a head frame, and you could actually make it work if you wanted to. I'm going to cut down into my layout so it goes down below the surface, and I'm able to pull it back up. So anyway, I will get that head frame set up and just let you see how it works, and we'll finish up the video. Okay, guys, here we are back. I was going to tell you, when you build this thing, make sure that... and I should have done it earlier, and I was just in a hurry for the video, is make sure when you glue this, the main centerpiece on there, that you do make sure it's 90 degrees to the base. This one is off it's just a hair. I mean, you can see, it's just barely any. But anyway, what it does, it kind of makes it tight on, you can see the other one in here. This is the track it's going on. You can see how I've marked the track when I put it in to make sure I got centered and vertical. But anyway, this one travels. Let's see if I can back up. This one travels really easily up and down. I tried to run the new one in, and it's just a little tight. All you would have to do is thin down the track, the width of the track a little bit. This is just under 3/8 of an inch, so you have to take like a 1/4 by 3/8 inch piece of wood and just shave off. I actually got a little the MicroMark table saw, and I would just cut down until it moved up and down the track easily. And I tacked this in place and did a test run before I ever glued anything in permanently. So anyway, you just want to make sure that it tracks on the track okay. You see it moves up and down easily. This is a little right at 4 ounces, so it's plenty of weight. I will change this thread out to a cable. Also have a bearing that I made and the pulley that goes on top. So anyway, this all works, and for my mine scene, I will, like I said, I will drill a hole and make sure that or not drill a hole, but cut a hole so this will go down into the ground. It looks like it's going down and pulling stuff up. I'm also thinking that I made two levels where it can stop here at the bottom and here on the side so I can bring the car out to go dump. Anyway, I have nowhere near finished this head frame. I've still got a lot of work to do on it. This is just kind of the mock-up. If you're interested in using this mine cage, I will have the dimensions available so you can use this. But it's going to make a pretty interesting scene on my layout. This mine cage will be available from tiesplanes.com. If you have any questions, feel free to call. You can visit my webpage, and it has all the stuff you need, all the contact information you need. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope it helps. Y'all have a good day.